All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Jonathan Fievez. He's the CEO of Carnegie Clean Energy. And Jonathan, it's good to see you. You're at our OTC studios in New York City. Nice to see you.
Yeah, thanks, Steve. Yeah, it's great to be here in New York. Haven't been here for a few years.
Good stuff. Well, we've got lots to talk about. I know you've had some news out today, and we'll talk about that in just a second. But for people not familiar, Carnegie Clean Energy out of Australia, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, we're a long way from my home, but yeah, we're increasingly looking at the US for opportunities, and I think there's some emerging.
Yeah, tell me a bit about the company.
Yeah, so Carnegie Clean Energy is a wave energy technology developer. So we're converting ocean waves into electricity. So, you know, waves that would move ships up and down, or people would surf, you know, they're the kind of waves that we can convert into electricity. And the great thing about wave energy is it's super consistent and predictable, and it's 24/7 around the clock.
Yeah, I know that you've struck a deal with a company called SKF. That's the news that's out today. And this is a partnership that really benefits both companies. Maybe you can kind of explain to us the terms of the deal and why it's so important to your company.
Yeah, so SKF are a large sort of European industrial manufacturer of bearings and seals and shafts, the kind of drivetrain components that are really critical to a technology like Carnegie's CETO technology. And we're getting to the final stages of the construction for our what we call our Achieve project in Spain, where we're going to deploy our CETO technology offshore at a really good wave site in the Basque Country in Spain. So yeah, it's great to sign up SKF as a sort of manufacturing partner for that project. They've been busy in the last few months with designing this core part of, you know, the technology. It's really the heart that converts the motion of the device into electricity. So yeah, I mean, it's essential to have these kind of manufacturing relationships. So when we scale up, we're scaling with a really competent partner.
And you know that you don't have to worry about the supply chain issues because you've got that sort of already patented down, which I think is important.
Yeah, look, it's really critical to have that supply chain on board with you. And SKF are not just any company. You know, they've got an ocean energy group, so a group that's very focused on this emerging technology and this emerging space. They're a lead partner in Ocean Energy Europe, which is a European peak body for ocean energy. So yeah, they're really big fans of the sector. They can see where it's going, and it's you know, how big a deal it's going to be in the future.
Jonathan, you talked about the work that you're doing in Spain, and this deal really sits around that. Obviously, it's a good starting point for the company, but I know you want more. What kind of areas in the world are you targeting other than Spain for that you think would really benefit from the CETO technology?
Yeah, well, it's a really globally applicable technology. Wherever there's great waves, and that's a lot of places. I mean, that's the thing about wave energy. It is globally distributed. And, you know, with many cities on the coasts of countries, you know, the consumers of this energy are right there where we can produce it. So, for instance, the west coast of Europe has great waves. We're talking Spain, Portugal, France, the UK, Ireland, parts of Scandinavia. Of course, Australia, where this technology is from, is blessed with amazing wave resource. And, of course, the US. So in the kind of northern parts of North America, particularly Alaska, Oregon, down the coast in California, you know, you've got some amazing wave energy resources. And of course, huge population centers that are thirsty for renewable energy that's around the clock.
Yeah, you mentioned California, desperate for energy for sure.
Yeah.
Tell me a bit about, you're at, as I mentioned, at the OTC studios in New York City, you are on the OTCQB. I'm just wondering how important that market is to you and the company, and really how you see the investor in America.
Yeah, so we kind of were born in Australia, so to speak. So we've been very much an Australian technology so far. But what we're seeing is really the US is actually emerging as with a strong interest in wave energy. We're seeing laws passed in California. We're seeing the Department of Energy building a site in Oregon near Portland. And then some funding around bringing companies that have, I guess, been working in Europe and Australia and other places, bring them to the US, and getting that wave energy sector started, because solar and wind can't do what wave energy can do, in the sense that we can bring around the clock energy. Nighttime, when the wind's not blowing, we've got waves still crashing on the shore. So it's an amazing opportunity for the US, and we haven't told our story here. People don't know about us here. So last few days I've been doing investor presentations, and there's a lot of excitement around what we can do.
Jonathan, thank you so much for giving us an update on where you're at. Good luck with everything, and we look forward to following your story, okay?
Thank you, Steve.
All right, good stuff. There is a Jonathan Fievez. He's the CEO of Carnegie Clean Energy.